glued this thing again, and I want to leave it overnight. And yeah, see how we go. What I did, it was actually opening up in these spots. That's what that high-pitched noise was, what you could hear when I was turning. It was the vibration. So I glued these on the outside, and then using the tape like a clamp to help close it up. Might help if I was actually filming what I was talking about, wouldn't it? And then I'll leave that overnight. But yeah, finally got out to do some more progress. I think this is going to be the finished size. Just got to clean up tool marks. And there's a ridge there. Sanding might take it out. I might use the 40 grit gouge on it. But yeah. Finally got out to do a little bit more. And I think I'm going to go and do some more fencing now. This is where I'm currently fencing. There's Zohan up the top there. These girls are pregnant. And due not until first week of October, I think. Big boy, the visiting ram. What are you doing? Hey, you're going home soon, aren't you? Hey? Cheeky shit. Getting on the other side of the dam, cheeky buggers. And that's, the sun's in the way. Trying to get, see where I'm doing the fencing that's laying on the ground there. To go up right up into that top corner there, you can pop the sun's in the way. All right, better get to it. All right, this is the corner post. I'd forgotten I'd already bought wire up here ready to run out down. I use as a guideline where the fence line's supposed to be. Bit out of breath here. We're using wallaby mesh. It's got a skirt in the bottom that goes on the outside of the fence. Stops the wallabies from digging under. It doesn't look like it, but that's bloody steep. We had a guy here for 20-ton excavator to help clean out the dam. It was a tiny little thing, probably not even that big. So, but he came up here and he discovered that the fence line was on the wrong spot. This is where they had it originally, and we think it was because there's too much scrub up here. But he got up here and he was nearly tipping a 20-ton excavator over. Yeah, full boom reach and scraping off as much as he could. As you can see, a lot of the bracken fern's growing back. But I've got to go. Hard to see around these trees. Straight down, and you can't quite see it. Right there. There's a post. So, yeah. This is the last bit of perimeter fencing I've got to do to keep the animals in, or keep the sheep in. They've been getting up in and around here, which is forestry. And yeah, forestry don't like you going on their property. So we better fix that. All right. usually wait until I've done at least up to 240 grit, but looking at this, there's a fair bit of movement in this, and I want to try and get some of this shellac into the grain. And what, I sanded all that off. Not to worry, I'm going to be sanding it anyway. Lovely. I'll give this time to soak into here anyway. I usually use 1 pound cut shellac. I'm actually using 2 pound at the moment, only because I don't have any 1 pound mixed up. And just using one of the 80 grit discs at the moment. Oh wow. I can see light through that one. We might be filling that in. This is a good example of why on some bowls you need to use a tenon where it's compressing the wood. If I had have used a recess where I'm got the jaws are pushing outwards, this probably would have blown apart. Oh yeah, that cracks pretty bad, I can feel, right? Oh, I guess we'll see if we can save it. It took plenty of time to soak in. Oh, I should really clean that off with some FO first. Left in this, soak that. This is where, in one of Robbo's videos, live videos he did recently, you're saying paper towel. It's a good example of what it does. It just rips up and leaves crap everywhere. At the moment, I'm not really too worried about that. That'll do. Getting the pen off there. I just want to get the shellac into the grain too. A bit of movement there. Trying to get into the grain and then that crack. I don't know if you can see that, but you can see the light through it. I can at this angle anyway. Not sure if we'll be able to save this one or not. It might be a practice one. Not really concerned how the shellac looks into the grain at the moment, so I'm just trying to get it into the grain to help. It's kind of like using a sanding sealer.
deeper than that. I am rubbing fairly hard on this to try and get the shellac into the grain. And nearly there. Have to make some more of this up soon, eh? The shellac goes off pretty quickly, as you can see, because of the mefo or denatured alcohol for overseas people would call it that. Only takes as long as the alcohol to evaporate for it to go off, really. Well, I'm impressed with that. Hey. I'll let that dry, sand the inside, see how we go. So sanding this just with the 80 grit pad, I think I'm going to do the same with this just to try and help stabilize it a bit. And just put the shellac on it and maybe let it harden overnight. It's probably a little bit thinner than what I probably should have done, but these are the things that we do. This paper towel has just had it. Not impressed with that stuff. I won't be buying that again. And I usually only use it to wipe down a piece, just to give it a bit of a clean up. And then it gets thrown in the fire. The other good thing of using mefo, you don't actually necessarily have to wait for it to dry before putting shellac on it. Got a nice paper towel. Oh dear. This will give us an idea of how it might look too when it's finished. As I said before, this might end up being a practice piece. I'm not really concerned about it. I just want to get it into the grain, try and help stabilize things a bit, and then let it harden up. You'll see the sanding marks and stuff in there, but soaking it up, which is good. Sometimes these are the trials and tribulations of what woodturners have to go through, that people that buy the pieces don't actually realise what actually goes into some pieces. Some pieces are easy and not problematic at all. And sometimes you just get a piece, you do a lot to it and it takes more finishing or more working with the piece to actually get it to a finished product. And that's mainly why I do my videos. I'm not really interested in doing the monetization or making money from the videos themselves. Also, sort of people that buy a product or receive a product from me can actually see what went into making it. And even if it's not the same product that they bought, it gives them an idea of what goes into it. Even for new turners, that's cutting that up. That's another reason for stiffening these fibres up. If I get that soaked in the there, and it'll, as I said, stiffen the fibres up, it'll make it better for sanding. Pretty much like what a sanding sealer will do. Sanding sealer will also help you for applying other finishes to stop them soaking in so much, so you're not using as much of your really good product. I've just been using shellac all the way through. It's just a preference. You don't have to do it. See, it gets a bit messy on the fingers, but it is a natural product, so it's not like it's going to poison you. The mefo is probably the only thing that's probably not real good for you. It's not like I'm drinking it. You want to drink it, it's up to you, but I don't recommend it. Get plenty of it in here. And I think I might even leave this just tearing up this cloth. Here I'm going to maybe even have to send it past the CA, otherwise I'm going to get these lines in here. Put some more on the outside too. This is going a lot further on top of the already dry stuff, and it will soften up the previous coating. And that's where you don't want to go over, back over areas that are too wet or still hardening up, because it will lift it off. And I think that's where most people Think, oh my god, there's another big crack in here too. We might actually turn this bowl into something else. Firewood. I can actually see through that. That's not good. I'm going to have to check that wood, I think, before I turn any more of it. Well, I might leave that. Shellac all over the place. Alright, cleaned up with alcohol, so it's all good. Mefo. So I think I might leave this as part two for now. And, yeah, I might need to leave this, just let it settle down for a little while. And, let that shellac harden up. That crack, you can see daylight through it. Oh, I can for the light. One there. Is it there? It there. There's that one there. And this one here. I can see daylight through that too. You want to hold it up to the light. So I may need to glue those. So that can also be used as a barrier for certain things as well. Much like people use a wax before putting down any finishes or paints or anything like that that they don't want to get into other areas of a project. Now you can see why I used a tenon, because if that was a recess, that would have pulled apart and it'd be on the other side of the workshop probably. Not that I turn that fast. Some people I've noticed lately are turning way too fast. Way, way too fast. This turning, I've never got over 800 RPM. There's just absolutely no need for it. You're just creating more of a danger issue for yourself. But that's personal choice too. If you want to turn a bowl at 3000 RPM, go for it, but just don't be surprised when it blows apart on you. And if you did that in my workshop, you'd be kicked out. Not having people demonstrating that kind of thing in my own place. That's my personal preference, though. It's a shame, because that would have been a nice bowl. It may still turn out to be a nice bowl. But I think we're going to leave it for a little while. Here's another one I need to finish off. So that's got a recess. But with no issue with that coming apart. This is Blackwood. Had a couple of coats of CA, and I've left it sit for a little while to let it settle down and de-stress a little bit. That I might leave in there. I might, but these ones here, I've got a, yeah, stress fractures, I think. And they've obviously radiated from here. Now this was a completely seasoned and dried bowl, or piece of wood, and it's still cracked. So it still had some moving to do, obviously, but yeah, it's another one we'll get onto and finish real soon. right, folks, it's getting cold out here, so I'm gonna leave you there.